Hey there, I'm Mike, and today we'll be going over how you can fix a 403 forbidden error on your WordPress site. Did you just try to access your WordPress site only to be hit by some message telling you something is forbidden or that you don't have permission to access something on your site? If so, you've likely run into the 403 forbidden error on your WordPress. Seeing an error on your WordPress site can be frustrating and deflating, which is why we've created this detailed guide to help you fix the 403 forbidden error on WordPress and get your site functioning again as quickly as possible. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, I know you want to get your site fixed, so let's get started. First, file permissions. Each folder and file on your WordPress site server has its own unique file permissions that control who can read or see the data in the file or view the contents of a folder, who can write, modify the file, add or delete files inside a folder, or execute, run the file and or execute it as a script, access a folder and perform functions and commands. These permissions are indicated by a 3-digit number, with each digit indicating the level of permission for each of the three categories I mentioned. Normally, these permissions just work for your WordPress site. However, if something gets messed up with the file permissions at your WordPress site, it can cause the 403 forbidden error. To view and modify your site's file permissions, you'll need to connect via FTP or SFTP. For the screenshots you'll see in this video, we'll be using the free FileZilla FTP program. The basic principles will apply to any FTP program, though. You'll just need to apply them in a different interface. Once you're connected to your server, you can view a file or folder's permissions by right-clicking on it. Of course, manually checking the permissions for each file or folder isn't really an option. Instead, you can automatically apply file permissions to all the files or folders inside of a folder. According to the WordPress Codex, the ideal file permissions for WordPress are files, 644 or 640, directories, 755 or 750. One exception is that your wp-config.php file should be 440 or 400. To set these permissions, right-click on the folder that contains your WordPress site. The folder name is public at Kinsta. Then choose file attributes. Enter 755 or 750 in the numeric value box. Then choose recurse into subdirectories and apply to directories only. Once you've applied the correct permissions for directories, you'll repeat the process for files. Only this time, enter 644 or 640 in the numeric value box. Choose recurse into subdirectories. Choose apply to files only. To finish the process, you just need to manually adjust the permissions for your wp-config.php file to make them 440 or 400. If the file permission issues were causing the 403 forbidden error, your site should now start working again. Second, .htaccess file. Kinsta uses the Nginx web server, so this potential issue doesn't apply if you're hosting your site at Kinsta because Kinsta sites do not have an .htaccess file. However, if you're hosting elsewhere and your host uses the Apache web server, one common cause of the 403 forbidden error is a problem in your site's .htaccess file. The .htaccess file is a basic configuration file used by the Apache web server. You can use it to set up redirects, restrict access to all or some of your site, amongst other functions. Because it's so powerful, even a little mistake can cause a big issue, like the 403 forbidden error. Rather than trying to troubleshoot the .htaccess file itself, a simpler solution is just force WordPress to generate a new, clean .htaccess file. To do that, connect to your server via FTP. Find the .htaccess file in your root folder. Download a copy of the file to your computer. It's always a good idea to have a backup just in case. Delete the .htaccess file from your server after you have a safe backup copy on your local computer. Now you should be able to access your WordPress site if your .htaccess file was the issue. To force WordPress to generate a new clean .htaccess file, go to Settings, then Permalinks in your WordPress dashboard. Click Save Changes at the bottom of the page. You don't have to make any changes, just click the button. And that's it. WordPress will now generate a new .htaccess file for you. Third, deactivate and then reactivate your plugins. If neither your site's file permissions or .htaccess files are the problems, the next place to look is your plugins. It could be a bug in a plugin or a compatibility issue between different plugins. No matter what the issue is, the easiest way to find the problematic plugin is with a little trial and error. Specifically, you'll need to deactivate all of your plugins and then reactivate them one by one until you find the culprit. If you can still access your WordPress dashboard, you can perform this process from the normal plugins area. If you cannot access your WordPress dashboard, you'll instead need to connect to your WordPress site server via FTP or SFTP. Once you've connected to your server via FTP, browse to the WP content folder. Find the plugins folder inside the WP content folder. Right-click on the plugins folder and choose Rename. Change the name of the folder. You can name it anything different, but we recommend something like plugins-disabled to make it easy to remember. By renaming the folder, you've effectively disabled all the plugins on your site. Now, try accessing your site again. If your site is working, you know that one of your plugins is causing the 403 forbidden error. To find the culprit, reactivate your plugins one by one until you find which plugin is causing the issue. After changing the file name of the plugins folder, you should see a number of errors that say the plugin file does not exist when you go to the plugins area on your site. To fix this issue and regain the ability to manage your plugins, use your FTP program to change the name of the folder back to plugins. So if you've renamed it to plugins-disabled, just change it back to plugins. Once you do that, you'll see the full list of all your plugins again. Only now they'll be deactivated. Use the activate button to reactivate them one by one. Once you find the plugin that's causing the issue, you can either reach out to the plugin's developer for help or choose an alternate plugin that accomplishes the same thing. Fourth, deactivate CDN temporarily. If you're getting 403 forbidden errors on your assets, like images, JavaScript, CSS, it could be a problem with your content delivery network. In this case, we recommend temporarily disabling your CDN and then checking your site to see if it works. If you're a Kinsta client, click into your site and then on the CDN tab. Click the Disable CDN button. Fifth, check to see if the Hotlink protection is misconfigured. Hotlinking is when someone adds an image to their site, but the hosted link is still pointed to someone else's site. To prevent this, some will set up what is called Hotlink protection with their WordPress host or CDN provider. When Hotlink protection is enabled, it will typically return a 403 forbidden error. This is normal. However, if you're seeing a 403 forbidden error on something you shouldn't be, check to make sure your Hotlink protection is configured properly. Remember to follow these steps to help you fix your 403 forbidden error. File permissions, htaccess file, plugin issues, CDN issues, Hotlink protection. If you've tried these solutions and you're still having issues, then we recommend reaching out to your hosting provider. They can most likely help you pinpoint the issue and get you back up and running. If you're a Kinsta client, open up a support ticket with our team. We are available 24/7. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to get notifications for the remaining videos in this series, and of course, other tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.